Wanted to buy copies of my book to put in their library, which she ended up doing 2 weeks later. I couldn't believe the impact my one email and my connection with Michelle had on this whole group of women in Vancouver. When it came time to say goodbye to Michelle that day, that was definitely the hardest part. I had no idea if I would ever see her again.
I got the courage to write her an email, and I sat on it, and sat on it, and I finally pressed send. And my daughter responded 10 days later. And she gave me the most horrible description of how angry she was at me. And I must have jumped in the air 5 feet, that I was so grateful that she wrote me back. I didn't care what she called me.
At this point, I had lost it completely. And so had they. And they listened to me, and they listened to my story, and I told them how my mother got up, and if she hadn't got up, I wouldn't be here today. But she got up, and she kept forward, she kept moving forward. I told her how, about 10 years after the war, she met my father in an elevator on their way to a dance for victims of the war, displaced people. And I told them that my father spoke to her in the elevator. They got up to the 10th floor and decided to go back down. And 3 months later, they got married. And I told them that's where I learned the value of a good elevator pitch.